Thank you for tuning in one more time to Resurrecting Your Spirit Ministry. My name is Pastor The Past, and today we will be studying from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 24. We're going to lay the foundation down and try to explain to you briefly about the culmination of this age. We want you to understand that our beloved Father did not intend for this world to be in a stage that it is today. We want you to understand that our Father did not stay in the heavenly places and look down and see our sufferings and say, deal with it. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall call upon the name of it shall be saved. We want you to comprehend in the deep passport of your conscience that God has laid out the laws in the first five books of his word. We want you to understand that the Levitical priesthood back then was in charge of everything. The Levitical priesthood was in charge of the welfare. It was a welfare department for the widows, for the fatherless and the motherless. We want you to understand that the Levitical priesthood, they were the doctors and the nurses and the midwives. We want you to understand that the Levitical priesthood was the one who would come to your house when you had an evil spirit or when you had a mold in the wall. We want you to understand that the Levitical priesthood was the one who gave out the rites and did the sacrifices for your sins to be forgiven. We want you to realize that God has a royal priesthood right now. He has a royal priesthood, a spiritual Levitical priesthood that's been called from the foundation of the earth. We want you to understand that the biblical teachings of the Levitical priesthood are still in order today, with exception of the blood sacrifice and the blood rituals. We have the blood of the high priest, Melchizedek, Jesus, Yeshua, the Christ, the ultimate sacrifice for our sins. In the altar, the most holy of all is, we have the lower altar and the upper altar. And God commanded Aaron to put certain symbolism on the altars. You have the sea salt on the altar. You have the frankincense and the myrrh burning at the altars. You have the cayenne pepper, which is fire, and the brimstone, which is sulfur, on the altars of the Levitical priesthood. We want you to understand the symbolism of the power of these symbols that the enemy does not like. And we want you to understand that the devil had a plan to infiltrate and destroy the way of God had planned for this earth to be, to give us a second chance of the opportunity where we will have the choice to either accept Christ or deny him. But the devil had another plan, and it's called the generation of the fig trees. The generation of the fig tree started in the garden. It started in the garden when the serpent came to the woman. In Genesis chapter 3, we read that the woman was tempted by the devil. The word serpent is the synonymous of his name. You know the serpent doesn't have a vocal cord. So you see that the word of God speaks in symbolism, figure speech, parables, in order for you to study, for you to dig deeper into the word of God. And we find here that in Genesis 3, we're going to do a quick over all, we find that the serpent lied to the woman and told her in verse 3 and 4 and 5, we will read. But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Now, in the original commandment that Father gave to Adam and Eve, it's documented in Genesis 2:17. During the temptation and the conversation between Satan, which is the serpent, which is the tree of good of knowledge and evil, was added on the word touch. It says, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Pull out your strong concordance and look up the word touch. The word touch in the Hebrew is 5060. It says to touch means to lay your hands upon and to lie with a woman, meaning sexual intercourse. So somehow the commandment got twisted. In verse 5 it says, for God don't know, this is what the serpent says, that in the day that you eat thereof, then your eyes shall be open, and you shall be of gods, knowing good and evil. And she believed it. Verse 6, and when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and the tree to be desired, and to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. Meaning that also Adam was a partaker of the same sin. Adam was disobedient along with his wife Eve. They both partook of that tree called the tree of good and knowledge and evil. And the act says here, to touch, to lay upon, and to lie with a woman. The second word we want to find is the word beguile. We look here in the same chapter, and we see that when God saw the sin of Adam and Eve, he asked them, he said, and their eyes were open, both of them were open, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed together fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. They made aprons out of fig leaves because the act of Naga took place in a fig grove. And the word of God doesn't lie. Especially when you study the manuscript, especially when you get the strong concordance and you start digging deep into the word of God. The gold and the silver is there, but you got to dig for it. In order to reach for that precious treasure and that diamond and that silver and that gold and that pearl, you got to dig deep.